Thank you. But we can't In other words, even though you're not what needs to be concerned with the about you, just because you're Muslim doesn't mean that we are infallible, that we cannot be quite where we have a way. And in other words, the prophet is not just the person and the celestial, but the person is being a model. Not only the model of the life of course, but on a Hassana, a beautiful life. A beautiful man, a beautiful man. Why is he a man? Because not only is he a man, he is the outside of a person is the inside of a human being. honor and defend that you shall not from what you have, but what you wear. In that, in the life of Carter, indeed the most honorable of you, the most powerful of the country, honor the good life of the people of the country,
Thank you.
the prophet Muhammad replied that he said, "O Fatima, who is it but the Holy?" Fatima said, "O my father, I do not know. But this person is talking and he's telling him to go away." The prophet is, "O Fatima, don't you know who that is? That is that mother, that angel who needs no permission to enter into any home apart from your home. O Fatima, this is the man who mourned my grandmother. Another one of the children, and this is a prophet passed away in the hands of Fatima. Most of them wishing and suffering. But ya Rasulullah, look at Father Umar sleeping, your death of family after you passed away. Soon after you passed away, they came to the house of Fatima. They threatened him to burn him. They came to the house of Fatima. They had horrified him and he started to come off, but he did not do well. A time comes when Fatima comes to the mosque of Medina. He appeared to the Sahaba and he said, "Oh, people, where are your conscience? Doesn't the Quran say, 'Ma Muhammadin illa Rasul'? Afa in mata wa kutiba in talaqina wa aqabikum? Muhammad is nothing but a prophet. Is he dying? Or is he still when he turned back? Or people, why have you come back from us? Are we not the Ahlullah? Doesn't the Quran be preached in our home? But that is not sufficient to her. At times when we are prophet, not only is he a fire arrow as Hassan, but one to Karbala and see what that is to her soul. And the God of the evil are you. And for saying he's sitting outside his tent, he told him all and his sister came and confessed to him. And she said, "Oh, he said, brother, don't you see the army to cross you?" Hussein opened his eyes and he said, "Ya Allah, oh my sister, I just seen our grandfather in my vision." And he said, "Ya Hussein, I'm the Baruch on you, and Hussein, you're coming to us, we're waiting for you." And the Baran Hussein, on the day of Ashuru, that Saddam Hussein remembered his grandfather as well. That's what he when Ali Akbar was going to the battlefield, as Ali is going, Hussein is walking behind him. Ali Akbar looks behind him, "Oh my father, you have given me permission to go. Why are you following me?" Hussein turns towards the sky and he says, "Ya Allah, you bear witness that that son of mine is going to the battlefield, who in his nature, in his behavior, in his speech, remember your prophet more. Whenever I wanted to remember your prophet, I would look at Ali Akbar and hear in the prophet and his mother at the final prayer in Sayyidina. When Sayyidina comes, he kisses the neck of his wife and he sees the head. This is the Wasiya of our mother. Hussein kisses the hand of Sayyidina. Why are you kissing my hand, dear?" He said, "This is the Wasiya of our mother also, because the husband will now be found with us. With shame, I don't know how to say, my final prayer to the head is that Hussein is on his toes, preparing to go to the battlefield for the final fight. Nobody's left alive, but the heart of the man." He said, "Hussein said, 'Oh, my heart, take me to the battlefield.' But the heart of the man, he looks down on my duty, which is looking at having the legs of the heart. 'Do not take my father to the battlefield. Run away to the battlefield. He does not come back alive.' Hussein comes to the man. He put the Tina on his lap, and the Tina left him to go. The Tina did not let her father go. Suddenly she got to sleep, and then she answered and she said, 'Oh, my father, you may go now. You may go to the battlefield.' But the Tina was hurting. She said, 'Oh, my father, when I sleep, I saw my grandmother in my vision. Oh, the Tina, do not deny anything to her.'"